Life used to be so simple, you were living on Easy Street. But you were set spinning, find you have to land on your own two feet. What you gonna do in this strange new place when things come down to the light? Two is fine company, the three is gonna make it alright.
A special one, so get lost.
Bet you can't hit the bell.
Easy.
Don't hurry, old Newman will hear it.
He'll take it off, yeah?
Oh, sucks to Newman the pony.
Hey, look at Harvey.
He'll get into trouble.
Dead-eyed Dick. Come on, Pickle, hand it over.
It wasn't me, sir.
Then who was it? The castle ghost? There's no one else here, is there?
No, sir.
Then it must have been you, mustn't it?
No, sir.
Come on, hand it over.
Please, sir, it was Harvey, sir.
Oh, yes. Come on, Kepanui, out you come. And you boys in those bushes, come on. Quickly now. Chris, get the ball, football practice. Now, come on, Harvey, hand it over. Right, off you go. Football practice.
Sir, when do we get our shanghais back?
We'll see how you go after football practice.
Guys, we'll never get anywhere arguing about it. Now, let's do it again.
Okay, that's enough for today. Now, Pickle, it's up to you. Tony and Harvey are passing you the ball, and you have to catch it, right? OK, the bus leaves the school at 12 o'clock tomorrow. And don't forget your pyjamas.
I don't wear them, sir.
You borrow your auntie's nightie then, Harvey. And don't forget your swimming togs.
But, sir, it's too cold for swimming.
They've got a heated pool in the city. Now off you go home. Oh, yes. Do you think you deserve them?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Here. I don't want to see them at school again. And that goes for you too, Pickle.
Come on, I'll give you a jewel.
What do I want to jewel you for?
What's the matter? Are you scared?
No, but I've got to go to a mad dog gang meeting anyway. Listen, you're not a member, so just shove off.
Anyway, the mad dog gang's done.
Yeah, Pickle Pie can't even catch a ball yet.
Yeah, Pickle Pie, the Shanghai King. Couldn't hit an elephant if he'd stand you. Come on, gang.
and all our stuff.
Tell him that he's not allowed.
Yeah, but that won't stop him.
Hey, I know. We could make a booby trap.
Yeah. That's a good idea.
We could use this and fill up with stuff. When he comes in the door, it'll drop on his head.
Yeah, we can fill up all the dead birds.
Yeah, and snails and wetters.
Yeah, and spiders.
Hey, but where are we going to get the stuff from?
Oh, come on, we'll look for it. Fertilizer, blood and bone, I think.
Yuck.
Hey, we could fill off that stuff.
Yeah. Pickle. Get out of here, Pickle!
Mad Dog Gang's a bunch of sissies.
You're just jealous.
Yeah, jealous because you're not a member.
Oh, I don't want to be a member of your smelly gang. Ha! The Mad Dog Gang's done.
Ah, Pickle Pie, I bet you I could beat you with a Shanghai.
I bet you can't.
Oh, we could beat you blindfolded. Yeah, easy.
Doesn't count. Anyway, we haven't warmed up yet.
Yeah, you got practice shooting at our roof.
All right, but this time I get two shots because there's two of you.
All right.
Shots.
I bet you can't shoot if it's dangerous.
Yeah, this is just sissy stuff. I bet you're no good if you might get caught.
I bet you're too scared to shoot in the haunted castle.
I bet you are too.
I already have.
When?
Don't have to tell you. Well?
I bet you're too scared to hit Walkie's weather vane when he's inside.
Yeah, I bet you're too scared for that.
All right.
I don't want to go there. Will you stay here and look after the hut? Oh, that's boring.
Come on, Pickle.
Anyway, Shanghai's are dumb.
How do we know if he's in there or not?
He must be. Look, he's got a visitor.
Come on.
hope Pickle comes now.
Alright, who's going first?
Tony, because he hasn't been first yet.
Alright, I'm not scared.
Get off. You ought to be more careful.
They're always hanging around at cheeky little devils. That's why I told you not to come here. Have you got the stuff in the van?
Of course I've got the stuff in the van. What do you think I come here for, a cup of tea?
You were supposed to take it straight to the hideout.
I don't know how to get there.
All right, what do you got?
Have a listen to this.
Gee. You idiot. I don't like this. I never have, you know that.
Don't be ridiculous. It's as safe as ours is. Vinky knows where it all is. I do the job. We bring the stuff here and keep it here until we're ready to ship it out. We can't go wrong. And come on, let's stow it.
Show you the way.
What were they talking about?
They had a radio.
So what? Everyone's got a radio.
Yeah, but why did Mr. Wilkie want to keep it hidden?
I don't know.
And hiding that stuff and shipping it out.
Yeah, like spies.
Yeah, a Russian spy.
Gee.
Pickle's chicken. At least he's a better shot than you and Harvey. Yeah, but he's chicken. He ran away. Anyway, me and Harvey saw some Russian spies.
You did not.
You were in there. You ask Harvey.
There aren't any spies here.
I bet there are.
You ask Uncle Eric.
No, it's their secret.
Auntie Maureen?
Yes?
Shh. Are there any Russian spies in New Zealand?
I don't know. You'd better ask your Uncle Eric.
You shut up, Suey.
Now that's enough of that language, young man.
Yeah. Uncle Eric, are there any Russian spies in New Zealand?
I don't know. I suppose they might be.
See.
Because Tony and Harvey reckon they saw one up at Mr. Wilkie's place.
Does he? Well, you won't find many Russian spies round here. There's nothing for them to spy on. Anyway, they're probably all up in Wellington. What were you doing up at Mr. Wilkie's place anyway? You weren't raiding his orchard again.
Nah, just exploring.
Well, you go exploring somewhere else and keep off Mr. Wilkie's place. You know he doesn't like kids.
You won't, Suey.
That's enough, you two. You ought to be getting to bed early for the big day tomorrow. And you don't want to be falling asleep when you get into town, do you?
Quiet, everybody, please.
Oh, I'll get a move on.
Right.
Everyone's to remain in the seats while we're driving, all right? And when we get there, you get out of the bus quickly and quietly and line up beside it. Quietly now. We don't want them city kids thinking you're a bunch of savages now, do we? Okay, Bert, chucks away. Come on, you lot, out you come. Come on, get a move on. Quickly now, line up beside the bus. Come on, you're out of the Mardi Gras now. Come on. Quickly now. Come on, you boys. Quickly. That's it. Hello, Mr. Chalk.
How do you do?
Right, everybody, this is Mr. Chalk. Now, he's going to read out your names, and when you put up your hands, he'll introduce the people that you'll be staying with tonight. Now, you've got this afternoon and this evening free, and your billets, that's the people that you'll be staying with tonight. I've got something organized for you. And they'll also bring you to the football field tomorrow, okay? Now, remember that you're guests, so please remember your manners. Thank you, Mr. Chalk.
Thank you. Hello, boys and girls. Thank you. Well, here are your billets. Murray Anderson with Peter Murphy.
Hi, I'm over here.
Alan and Chris Barker.
I hope I'll get on with Jay.
Now I want a sports car. Right,
you'll be stuck with a girl.
Peter Maxlow.
Come on.
Terry Benson with Tony Isaacs, the cheeky one. Tony, don't be shy.
Here you go.
Come on, off you go. Harvey Cabanui.
Here you go.
Lily Winston. Here you are.
Here we are, where you go.
And Tony and Susan Lane with Charles Spotter. Charles, where's Charles? Come on, Charles.
Okay, count to three. One. Two. Beat you. Oh, I don't care.
I could beat you, Willie.
No, you couldn't.
You watch me trick you.
Race
you to the other end.
Oh, I can't be bothered. I'll beat you, four eyes.
Yeah. Right, then let's go.
Okay.
Come on.
Swimming baths.
We don't like Charles going there by himself. There are too many rough children who go, and Charles isn't very strong.
We didn't have any trouble, Mum. Hey, do you want to watch telly? We've got a new one, a colour one.
Don't have it on too loud, because I've got some paperwork to do. Off you go.
Well, have you noticed anybody snooping around the place lately? Anybody unusual?
No, it's a very quiet street.
Ah, well, let's have a look at this description. Now, a big man.
A fat man.
With no face.
A big fat man with no face.
And thick glasses, big, big ones.
That, no face, and thick glasses.
And thicker than Tony's.
No face and very thick glasses.
And I bit his hand.
A big fat man, no face, very thick glasses, and a sore hand.
What do you think he was after?
Any money in the house?
Only a few dollars housekeeping.
Jewelry?
Nothing very valuable.
Could be anything. Radio, TV, stereo. Any important documents in the house?
No.
Well, thanks very much for your help. We'll do what we can.
Did they get him?
Nah, he got away long before they got there.
Well, what was he trying to steal?
Nobody knows.
But I think I know, because Charles' father told a lie to the police.
Come on, you lot. Hurry up. Get a move on.
Because he said there was no important documents in the house.
Tony!
Tell you later.
But what did he look like?
I don't know. Suey was the only one that saw him properly.
Come on, you lot. Out you go. Hurry up.
Gee, Pickle, can't you ever catch the ball?
Heck, Pickle, that club was in your fault.
I couldn't help it, my thumbs got in the way. They always get in the way. Why don't you try moving them?
Quiet! It was half-time anyway. If the ref didn't see it, there's nothing we can do about it. Now, what we need is more push in the forwards. And you guys in the back line have got to be snappier.
Pickle keeps dropping the ball, sir.
I do not.
You did so.
I couldn't help it. My thumbs got in the way.
Come on!
Didn't know you like football.
Don't, you fool. We're in trouble.
No, we're not, mate. We're winning.
Go, City! Now! Go!
I'm too risky doing them one at a time. You have to knock off a big one and get out of it, man.
Pass it out!
Have you still got that address?
What address?
Tiny fool. Here. I'll write it down for you. Try not to lose it.
Rock! Get in there and do them, you little beauties!
You idiot!
Come back, you kids, come back!
tray. Lost them. Now, which way's the van?
That's the quickest way.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
A sore hand, I can do all the driving.
Well, we know he was a big bloke. What else do we know?
He had long hair, sir.
No, short hair.
And curly.
It was not, it was straight.
And brown.
He had black hair.
It was fair.
It was short and fair.
And he had a big nose.
Hang on. Let's get this straight. He's a big bloke with thick glasses and a bandage on one hand, with long, short, curly, straight, black, fair hair, and a big nose.
No, sir, he had a small nose.
He had a big nose.
No, that was the little one. The big one had a small one.
Oh, I didn't even see their noses.
All right, that's enough. We got a big fella and a small fella. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
You say he tried to burgle your house last night?
Yes, sir.
And you say you saw him talking to a farmer out in the country?
We think so, sir.
You think so?
Please, sir, we think he's a spy, sir.
Oh, yeah!
A spy?
Yes, sir, a Russian spy.
Oh, that's rubbish.
Yeah!
Rubbish. How do you know you were there?
Quiet!
Yeah, well, the Wobbler had a secret radio which he was going to stash away until they got the submarine to pick them up, see?
I don't believe you.
You don't know, you ran away.
Yeah, you don't know anything, Pickle.
I still don't reckon he's a spy, that's just stupid.
Yeah, well, I know
about something else you don't know, so there, and that proves it.
But why didn't you tell the police?
Because it's a secret.
Yeah, mad dog gang's secret.
Mad dog gang's stupid.
You're just a cow, Pickle. You ran away.
You were too scared to go into the castle.
We were not.
You were so.
Pickle Pie's a yellow belly.
The mad dog gang's dumb.
Now, Pickle Pie's a yellow belly. Pickle Pie's a yellow belly.
Yeah, Pickle Pie.
Pickle Pie's a yellow belly. 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 Pickle Pie's a yellow belly.
There goes Sergeant Daniels after your spy, Tony, no doubt. Now, you just leave it to him, okay? And off you go home. Spies.
Come on, let's go to the meeting house.
But Auntie Maureen said we had to go straight home.
Fine, eh? Let's go there tomorrow and discuss our plans.
What plans?
The ones about the Russian spies, dum-dum.
Spies are dum-dums.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Come on.
Hey,
he wanted to buy the old castle. Strange idea. Did he know it's supposed to be haunted?
Yeah, that's why he wanted it.
Yeah, he's going to turn some sort of spooky hotel for tourists. Crazy idea.
Well, if you do hear from him again, would you let me know?
Yeah. What's he been up to?
Oh, no idea. Central up in town wanted to know. I don't think there's anything in it. We'll see you, Bert.
Yeah. Funny they knew he'd been up this way.
Yeah. Well, if you do see him again, will you let me know?
Yeah, sure.
You were too scared to go and shoot in the haunted castle when I bet you I could, see?
Well, maybe just a little bit.
Yeah? Well, I'm not. So stick that up your pipe and smoke it. You wait, I'll show you. Mad dog gang. Dumb dog gang.
Come on, Tony!
Thank you.
promise not to tell anyone.
All right.
Mr. Spotter had a file with New Zealand government. Confidential written on it, see? So that proves it.
What does confidential mean?
Secret, stupid. And New Zealand government, too.
But why does that prove that the Wobbly Man's a spy?
Gee, you're dumb. Because when the police asked if he had any important files in the house, he said no. And if it was really a secret, he wouldn't want to tell the police or anyone, because one of them might be a spy, you see, so that proves it.
Mm.
So don't you tell anyone, not even Uncle Eric and Auntie Maureen.
Spies are dumb.
Oh, you're dumb.
Do you think it could be the same bloke?
Well, who's to know? You know what kids are like. As for spies. Anyway, I thought I'd better let you know. Bert Wilkie was a bit annoyed by it all. He may be round. See ya.
Thanks very much. Bye. That's not the point. You keep away because I told you to keep away. It's on Bert's property and you're not to go near it. Anyway, it's dangerous. It's old and rotten. You could go through the floor or anything.
Yeah, but is it haunted?
Well, I don't know. Everyone says it is. The old goat who built it went mad and jumped off the tower. They say he haunts the place every sunset.
Gee!
Kid at your house. He's the only one who knows I'm around here.
Yeah, we'll have to clear out. Get all that stuff out of here.
We can't. We haven't got enough to pay for the petrol.
I don't care. I'm finished with it. All that stuff has to go.
Listen. We've already decided what to do. Me and Wink could do a big one tonight. Instead of these houses one at a time, we'll do a big one and we'll ship the whole lot out tomorrow. All right?
Thank you. Go, come on, quick!
You idiot. You gave me a terrible fright.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here? Oh, that's right. That kid. He was snooping around last night. Well, I tried to stay awake in case anybody came. Have you got the stuff?
No, Vinky's got it. He'll be here soon in the truck.
Yeah, well, he better hurry. Because if that kid tells his father, we'll be in real trouble.
We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. In the meantime, all we can do is wait.
We had to sneak out and we nearly got caught too.
Yeah, and we're going to be in trouble now too.
Hey, look who's coming. Get out of here. Pickle is the mad dog gang only.
Yeah, and you're not allowed.
But I've got something important to tell you.
We don't care. Anyway, we're going to have a mad dog gang meeting and you're not a member, so you're not allowed. Come on, gang.
Harvey? Why can't he be a member?
Because he's a yellow belly.
I am not.
Get him, man.
No.
But all those in favour of letting Pickle into the Mad Dog Gang.
And all those against. Come on, what do you vote?
I don't know. He is a good shot with Shanghai and he helped us in the chase.
And he says he's got something important to tell us.
So what do you vote?
But I don't think he should be a member until he's proved he's not a coward. But if we have the meeting at the window, he can stand outside.
I vote for that.
All right, then it's two against one.
Oh.
Harvey, look out, the booby trap!
All right, Pickle, you stand near the window. Come on, gang.
What are you going to tell us?
Come on, wakey, wakey, rise and shine.
I only just got home in time for tea. I was really scared, boy.
Did you tell your father?
I was too scared, and anyway, he doesn't believe there are any spies in New Zealand.
Well, we know there are.
I think we should go and tell Uncle Eric.
We can't. You know what he said about telling stories about spies last night? He'd only get angry.
Yeah, we'll have to do it ourselves.
Do what?
I don't know.
We can go to the castle and get some real evidence, then they'll have to listen to us.
Tony, we're not allowed. Uncle Eric said.
We have to.
Yeah! on, gang. You wait here, Suey.
Why do I have to do the dumb jobs for?
Because it's too dangerous for you.
Yeah.
I'm going home to tell Uncle Eric and you. You better not.
You'll just get into trouble for sneaking out this morning. You stay here and look after the hut. This will be headquarters.
Dumb, dumb headquarters.
Hey, that looks like the Wobbler's van. Yeah, Wilkie's tractor.
Hey, maybe they're waiting for the submarine.
Here.
What are you gonna do then?
You'll see.
Someone will see you.
I want to know when he arrives.
Oh, you'll know, all right. It's a big truck.
Why is he taking so long?
Come on.
Probably ran off to play because you were so grumpy last night.
Oh, for heaven's sake, spies. Have you ever heard anything so ridiculous?
Thank you.
What about this stuff? Yeah.
Hello, what are you up to?
Nothing.
Get it, old devil!
I'm a worried man. I don't believe in ghosts. I'm just curious, that's all. I mean, what does she do? Is head under the arm, huh? With her head tucked underneath her arm, she walks.
Now, you'd be so quick to laugh. No, I don't mind admitting I was a bit frightened last night.
Oh, don't tell me you believe in ghosts.
Nah, of course I don't. The bloke who killed this place was supposed to be nuts. I reckon he killed his wife and walks around at sunset with a bucket of blood pouring it over his head and singing a song. Or was it sunrise? I can't remember. Don't you worry. There's a lot of people around here that believe it. That's why it's a booming island.
What's the matter? You seen a ghost?
did you say in the morning?
Yeah, sunrise. Why? Did you see him? Look out behind you, there's a ghost!
Old Fred's hut. Don't they use that as some sort of meeting place? We'll look there.
Oh, I don't know. This whole thing's ridiculous. Spies, TV sets, meeting places. Introduce you to some friends of mine.
Let me go!
Come on, there's nothing up there. I think they're hiding in the trees.
Yeah, well, you stay here and keep a lookout.
You can't stay here all day, man.
I'm not coming back in here. It was running all down my face.
Don't be stupid.
Hey, come on. Hey.
Wait a minute. That's not blood, man. That's paint.
I keep watching over here. You think we'd better go?
Just give us another minute, will you?
to this.
Someone in there, man, and it's not a ghost.
Well, you go in the back way and I'll go in the front way.
Hey, we better cover it up.
Hey, the Wobbler's coming. I'm getting out of here. I'm going out the other way. You grab the catapult.
Gallagher! Hey, what are you doing here?
Come on, Harvey, out this way!
Uncle Eric.
This is a wild goose chase, you know.
I still say we have to go.
You'll get in as bad as the kids. And if they are up at Fred's old place, they're both going to get a good kick up the pants.
Let's flog something. And show up to the cops. They'll have to believe us.
Yeah, evidence. I saw some little transistor radios in one corner. We could flog one of those. But what about Suey? Oh, if we sneak in, they won't see us.
Yeah, we can show it to your Uncle Eric, because he's the closest. Come on.
Give us a hand with this.
Where's the kid?
He got away. But we'll have to get out of here. That kid's got a radio. He'll have Snoopy Daniels here before we know it.
No, it's all right. We'll load up now. We've already got the other girl. If anybody comes along, we'll use her. Come on, hurry up.
Thank you.
I think we'd better get Sergeant Daniels. I don't like the look of this.
I think you're right.
One more and that'll have to do it.
I've got an idea.
Castle? Boring. Run across to the house and ring Daniels. Tell him to get to Wilkie's castle.
See if Suey's okay.
Hey, come on, get the woman. Catch him, Harvey! Go help the boys!
Okay!
Oh!
Well, I'll be blowed. You got all three of them, eh? Well, they may not be Russian spies, but still you did a great job. Did you know there was a reward?
A reward?
Oh, beaut, the Mad Dog Gang's gonna be rich.
The Mad Dog Gang, eh?
That's us, sir.
And Pickle.
Yeah, us and Pickle.
I, Pickle,
swear
to be a faithful member of the Mad Dog Gang.
To be a faithful member of the Mad Dog Gang.
To never tell a secret to anyone.
Even under torture.
And to always look after other members of the gang.
Remember.
What do we do now? I know. Let's decide how to spend the reward money. Yeah! Yeah!
I sure don't get.